Love, pain, nostalgia. Year by year, it doesn't hurt so much anymore. Whatever effect it had, it's mixed in, like dye. Once dropped in, no changing the color back.
Hi, I'm Lana Condor, and I play Saya. Saya is a total badass. She is wanting to be the valedictorian of the school, which means she is the most talented. She is part of the Yakuza clan, and she is here to be the best, always.
She's like this really cool Japanese girl that Marcus finds very attractive, and he can't stop thinking about her.
What about her?
This young man's got his eye on the unobtainable Saya.
No, dude, no.
She's in the Kuroki Syndicate.
My character specializes in wielding the katana, which I have right here, and martial arts, and all things violent.
Run!
Saya is the most athletic and deadly character in the entire series, with the exception of Master Lin.
And there could be no one more qualified to play this role than Lana. She brings an incredible amount of discipline to this role, in the same way that Saya brings discipline to the order that she keeps within her gang and in her domain inside King's Dominion.
Whatever broken shit is inside of us is there the day we're born. People are what they are.
Saya is plagued by the burden and guilt of the family that she comes from in Tokyo, and it overshadows her character growth to the point where everything that she does is performance-based.
I'm gonna party forever and rule the world.
You have people that end up carrying the burden of a family legacy like Saya does, not by choice, but by demand. And she is somebody who has been given this responsibility by her father, who is now gone.
It was my father's. It's the only thing I have left.
There's a lot on the line. Her family's on the line. Her reputation's on the line. It's really, really important. And I think that inevitably she might give that up and choose friends over being the best, but we'll see.
Saya approaches surviving King's Dominion with walls up. She is very guarded because she's been hurt in the past and she doesn't want to let anyone in because she knows what it's like to be hurt, and that totally sucks.
I have my own rules, Bushido. Your honor lives in your sword, and I'm not leaving my honor in a closet next to some hot pockets.
But I think there's a lot more to her than just that, and she's gonna learn how to find, how to be able to express her feelings better.
You are so my best friend, do you know that?
Oh. You're so goddamn cool!
Saya is the only person that Maria has in her life. The only true friend, the only true relationship that she thinks she can count on. And I think Saya feels the same way.
Maria and Saya are very different characters. Their costumes are so completely different. You would think in real life, what would these girls have in common? But the strength is what they have in common. Maria is very showy, lots of jewelry, very sexy, whereas Saya is very, like, dark and understated, and they both have a very cool girl, strong sense about them. And you wouldn't think that they would be friends. There's a thread in there that makes their friendship really special. And it also, I think, breaks down some barriers where people don't expect these types of women to be friends, and yet they are.
Who gives a shit what those assholes think? The show revolves so much around friendships made with unlikely people, like kind of polar opposites in a way. And I think that's so important because it shows that no matter how different you think you are to someone else, that doesn't mean you won't become best friends with them. That doesn't mean you don't have anything in common with them. So I think that we're really exploring friendship with people we wouldn't expect to be friends with. And we're also really exploring what friends will do for each other. True friendship and friends can become your family.
Ever wonder what happened to your life? How you ended up here?
Ever heard of the red string? Many Japanese believe our relationships are predestined by a red string the gods tie around the pinky fingers of people who find each other. It might angle or stretch, but it never breaks.
And I think that's a really good message to show that friendships can be really, really hard, and friendships can suck sometimes. I think true friendships are worth fighting for.
What are you gonna do about it?
Throughout the show, we do a lot of fighting on our own, but we also fight together as a team. And partnerships and friendships
are the most amazing things in life. I hope that girls find their individual power and also realize that they can find support with other women as well.